This is Bosconian, also known as Star Destroyer Bosconian. It came out in November 1981 by Namco, and also Midway licensed it out as well.
Locked off.
The first thing you gotta note, it talked. It had speech synthesis, which was really, really cool. This is 1981, by the way. This is before the IBM PCs came out, right? This is a long time ago. This is when everyone had Apple IIs and Atari 800 computers. So this was really, really cool that it could talk. It would say things like blast off and alert, alert, and spy ship sighted and condition red and so forth. That's the first thing you would notice, and it was really, really cool. The second thing that was really cool is at the end of the game, when you got all your ships killed, you can continue the game. Now, Tempest came out earlier, but they had a different type of continue. But this is the one that you would end the game, and it would give you so many seconds, and you could pick up right where it left off. Now, that was really nice. I mean, that was a good way to get this game into arcades, because the owners can get more money, you know, the arcades, and that's kind of cool. The very center of the screen, you got a little ship there. It goes in the eight directions, and you just move what direction you want, and you fire in any of the eight directions. The object is to knock out these star bases, these green sort of looking hexagonal type star bases. You can either blow them up by shooting in the dead center of them when the shields are open, or knock out all six of those round bubbles on the outside. If you do that, it gets blown up. If you look at the right side of the screen where it's got yellow, well, that's conditions. You have condition green where there's no bad guys on the screen, condition yellow where there are, and if you take too long to finish a level, it goes to condition red and all the bad guys go twice as fast. So while you're trying to blow these guys up, they start sending out fighters and other guys to come knock you out, so you want to get these things done as quickly as possible. The right side of the screen also has that purple area, well, that's the radar. So you can see where all the bases are at, so you're not just flying around. This had a thing like on Galaga that if you went from level 255, it went back to level 0. And at level 0, it was kind of wigged out a little bit. But if you get past level 0, it goes back to level 1 like you had started the game over. So some of those games had a problem with the... I don't want to say a year 2000, it's like level 256 bug at that time. So that was kind of interesting. If you ever get that far, that's what happened. This was a kind of a fun game. When this had come out, I was cutting grass at a place called Johnny's Pizza Palace, not far from where I grew up, and they had this in there. So I would go cut the guy's grass, this is a pizza place, weeding it, and then go in and get my 10 bucks or 20 bucks or whatever it was, and they had a Bosconian in there, and so while I was waiting for the money, I'd be playing games. So I had fond memories of this game. This is actually a really, really good game. It was good today, it was good then. This is Bosconian from Namco, 1981.